What is the fractal, the pattern that we will see in financial market is this one. We talk about fractals. So we need to talk about a simple structure. 5-3 is too complex. Usoa is asking if we are going to learn Fibonacci. Yes, we will learn the basic of Fibonacci today. So the simplest structure is a zigzag, but the zigzag is coming from even a simpler structure, more simple, that is a straight line. So we will use a straight line to build up this fractal. And what we will do is divide this in three, and we will create the zigzag, okay? To create this zigzag movement and create higher highs and higher lows, the length that we need to use to connect in these divisions that we mark in the line, that is the initiator, is the basic structure that we will use. We need more length, and this length will define the fractal dimension. There are two formulas to find it, mainly that you can use. One is using this one. It's the log of the segments divided by the log of, these are the length of this tree, divided the length of the divisions that we have. If we measure, I measure the PowerPoint in this case, it was showing 0.8 three times, and in this case we have 0.8 three times, plus 0.95 that are the orange pieces. And this will return you the fractal dimension that was around 1.6, yeah, in this kind of structure. We created the zigzag, and this is our generator. Why? Because what we will do is start just iterating, doing the same here in any of the pieces of this fractal, and we'll repeat this infinite times, creating higher and lower degree scale zigzags. Okay? And we get this. We start just iterating the zigzag. Yeah, different sizes. We iterate. Keeping all the time the same time relationship, and we will get this. And when we see this, we start just iterating the zigzags, and we see, yeah, it can be a financial instrument, but really doesn't look like a financial instrument. Something in this iteration is missing. And what is happening here is that we need to keep in mind the time. Time is very, very important when we want to build this fractal, okay? Time is another piece of the iteration, and time will change and iterate also in different ways with the length. And that way, yes, we can create the iteration, something draw very similar simulation, very similar to a financial market. But then we are iterating two elements. We are iterating the lengths. Okay, at the beginning we did that, and we keep the same time, and we iterate that infinite times to get this. But we saw this is not really happening. We need to iterate also the time to make the movement faster or slower. That is what happened in the financial market. Sometimes we have really fast and strong movements. For example, the drop of the S&P during the corona was really a fast movement, okay? Very, very strong. What happened? We have a big length, but in a very short period of time, we are iterating the time. Yeah, and that is what will create something very similar to financial markets. Yeah, if we simulate in a model this. And that's why we talk then about a multi-fractal, because we're iterating, in this case, two pieces. We are iterating the price, and we are iterating the time, okay? And when we move, for example, we see different speeds, in this case, for the wave, for this motive wave and this corrective wave, okay? And this will change also the volatility. When we talk about the volatility in the market, the volatility is the standard deviation of the movements. But when the volatility is bigger, so that means that the movements are higher and probably faster. So when we move to the left side, we are increasing the volatility of the motive wave. And also we are decreasing the volatility of the corrective wave. Okay? They will balance each other. Yeah, but in one we increase volatility and in the other we decrease volatility. And the opposite if we move to the right side. Okay? So fractals, the basic pattern in financial markets is a zigzag, and this zigzag iterates in length, yeah, in price, and also in time. And when we talk about time, you have here a sample, and if you request a PowerPoint, you will have this graphic, and I encourage you to do this study and this research, because it's really important if you want to have accurate forecasts. All the waves that you see marked, they are marked with lines, green, red, green, and then blue and orange. All these waves are connected in length, yes, and in time. And you see this here, in this example here. So in this case, it's the pound dollar, and are the last movements. And we see in this table everything that is happening just here. You can continue the study and try to find some proofs, get some findings if you analyze a higher time scale. Okay, but if we see here, we have where the wave starts, where the wave ends, we have the length, and we have the time that took to the wave to finish, to mature. And it's quite nice to see the relationship between the length and between the time. If you remember the Fibonacci sequence, we have one number, it's 0618. In this case, we are very close to this number. 382, we are very close to this number. 1, we are very close. 1.5 is another one, we are very close. We are very close to 618, again, 0.5. 854, we are extremely close, and we are very close to 1. And that's telling us that the time is not random. So when we have, and this is really important, when we have a motive wave, the way that with this motive wave is built in length, in time, and also in speed, something we are not showing here, will connect with the corrective wave in the same, in length, in time, and in speed. So then we use this information to create what we call an attractor. An attractor is an area where the price tend to go. When the price or the quote reach this area, and we're talking about an area that is marked in length and also in time, then the price will be rejected and will move to the next attractor. Okay? And in this case, the next attractor can be here, or the next attractor can be here. Okay? But we will see, based on the development of the movements, once the attractor is reached, what is the highest probability pattern next to it. Okay? So we need to continue analyzing the market, because everything that is happening at this moment will condition it what will come later. Okay? That's very important. That's why we need to always see what's happening in the market and analyze every movement. Yeah? But this is very important. Then we say that the price, the quote, moves from one attractor to another, and those attractors are defined by length and by time, okay? And this is how the market iterates. And this is very important. So it doesn't matter the internal structure that you will have here. What for you needs to be really important is where to find the attractor. Because sooner or later, the price will reach this area and then you will have a reaction, okay? And that's how the market moves. And everything happened in zigzags. No five waves, zigzags. The basic structure is a three waves. And this iterates infinite times in the financial market, in length and in time.